In this problem, I want to calculate the mass of the product that forms. And we're given the thermite reaction, but we haven't balanced it yet. And this is used, it has a very high heat of reaction, and so it's used for welding metals. And we're going to start out with 25 grams of aluminum metal, 85 grams of the iron oxide, and the question is, how much iron metal, how many grams of iron metal are produced? And then which of the two reactants is the excess reactant? So anytime I have a chemical reaction, the first thing I want to do is balance the reaction before I do anything else. We have to work with a balanced reaction. So if I write the unbalanced reaction, so now I can choose how I'm going to do this. Let's say I have two irons on the left. That means I would have two metallic iron atoms on the right. And so that balances the iron. But now I need to also balance the oxygen and the aluminum. So if I put a 2 here, 2 aluminums on the left, 2 aluminums on the right, and 3 oxygen atoms on both sides. So it turns out to be relatively simple to balance. You always want to write down what we know. We start with 25 grams of this, 85 grams of iron oxide, and we want to know how many grams of this. And then which of these are in excess? So first we have to convert to moles. So first we look up the atomic weight. So I've used the periodic table to look up these atomic weights for the elements. So that means I can calculate the atomic weight of Fe2O3. And that atomic weight is going to be 2 irons plus 3 oxygens. Multiply those out. So I can use that to determine the number of moles of Fe2O3. And that's the number of grams. Multiply by, or in this case, divide by the grams per mole. So this is going to give me the number of moles of Fe2O3. So let's calculate now the number of moles of aluminum. We have 25 grams, and if we look up in the periodic table, the molecular mass, 26.98 grams for 1 mole of aluminum. So we calculate that, we get 0.927 moles of aluminum. And we look back at the reaction, we needed 2 moles of aluminum for 1 mole of the iron oxide. So we needed this much aluminum for a stoichiometric amount. We have less aluminum, so therefore this is the limiting reactant. And so that means that the iron oxide is in excess, which is one of the questions the problem was asking. The next question is, how much iron is produced? So we can see from the reaction that 2 moles of aluminum reacting makes 2 moles of iron. So if all the aluminum reacts, since it's a limiting reactant, that's possible, then we would end up with 0.927 moles of metallic iron. So now we go back to the periodic table again. We have 55.85 grams of iron for 1 mole. So if we do this multiplication units, we have grams of iron, 51.77 or 51.8 grams of iron.